A visionary teacher, he looks at the future, what he wants his students to be, how his hard work and toiling will impact and change the society in the future. Let me explain this with an example. There were three workers working on a construction site. They were building something. They were building a beautiful monument. A passerby, an observer, he happened to go and ask them, what are you doing? One of the workers said that I am earning my daily living. I am earning my bread and butter. If I do not work, my boss will not give me money. So I am earning my living. He asked the second person, what are you doing? He said that I am building a wall and it's a lot of hard work. He asked the third worker, what are you doing? And with a smile, a broad smile on his face and happiness, the third worker said that I am building a beautiful monument. The workers are same workers, same amount of time being spent, same amount of money being paid to them, same amount of efforts being put in. But the difference is in attitude. The first worker sees this as means of earning. And the third worker is a worker with a vision. As if he is visualizing that each brick he is laying is going to build a beautiful monument in the future. And this is going to affect his work, the passion in his work, the dedication in his work. You can take the example of a teacher. If you ask a teacher, what are you doing? You're coming to school every day, you're coming to your college or your university. And he says that I'm coming merely because this is my profession, this is my job, I earn money. And another teacher, he says that I come here because I want to create role models. I want my students to become the leaders in future. You can see and you will definitely notice the difference in the work of both. The second teacher will be more dedicated, more passionate and willing to work and sacrifice for the institute and for the students so that they may achieve their vision. And the mind of a student is like acres of land, a large field of uncultivated land. If you sow the seeds of goodness, you will yield goodness. If you sow the seeds of evil, you will have the fruits of evil. So a teacher with a purpose aims to cultivate this in the best way possible, in the best manner possible. This is a teacher with a purpose and the benefit of teaching with purpose. Another aspect and another feature of teaching with purpose and a benefit is that it creates good human beings. A teacher with a purpose, he emotionally engages, he physically energizes, he spiritually elevates the student and transforms them through the use of tazkiyah and tarbiyah to make them into good individuals, into good human beings. And let me remind you that good human beings are more important to the society. They are more important to our earth more than material resources, more than money and wealth.